Hello friends, welcome on this video. Daniel is here from Tips to Fix, and in this video tutorial today I'm going to show you 10 incredible tips that you are going to do right after installing Windows 11. So if you are on old laptop, unsupported computer, when you use that software or PC health check, it shows you that your processor or your computer is not supported. After you follow my guide to install on your unsupported computer, these 10 tips that I'm going to share with you guys right now will increase the performance on your computer, okay? In the other hand, I'm trying to make your adoption very comfortable, okay? You was using Windows 10 for a while, okay, or Windows 7, and working on Windows 10 and Windows 7, it was completely different thing. Now you are facing with new Windows 11, you see new start in the middle, you see new context menu and a bunch of changes on Windows 11. Today I'm going to make this transition very comfortable for you, okay? So let's go directly to the point and let's continue with tip number one. So the first thing that you are going to do right after installing Windows 11 on your computer, even if you are on old unsupported computer, or even if you are on a new laptop, go here on settings and check for system update, okay? Windows update, resume updates, and I will enable this option. Get the latest update, as you see guys, as soon as possible. Now I'm able to download the updates, and we have a cumulative update for Windows 11, 23H2, for 64-bit for system. This is very important. The first thing you got to do, go and check for update, install update, restart your computer, okay? Let's say that you need to have the latest drivers, audio driver, chipset, video driver, everything, okay? Then go here, advanced options. Then on advanced option, you will see. And if you see here, additional options, optional updates, click here. Then you will see driver updates. I have one driver update, is this one, Intel software component. You will see a list. If you are on old laptop, then you will see a list. Even if you are in your computer, you will see a list of the drivers. If you want to install drivers directly from Windows 11, then go ahead here, download and install, okay? Download and install is on the list now. So let's say that you are on the old laptop. This is not old, it's generation 8, but let's say that yours is old laptop, okay? And then you need to find the drivers. First of all, what you gotta do, you have to find your laptop model. Here, at the bottom of your laptop, you will see a code, okay? In my case, this laptop is Latitude 3500 model, okay? So you will see your model. Sometimes it's on your desktop, sometimes it's here. What you are going to do, you are going to find the model of your laptop, and then go ahead, let's say the Latitude 3500 drivers. This is how you will search on Google. Then you will see the official website, Dell or Lenovo or whatever. Open link. Then you will see here drivers and downloads. Choose the model that you have. In my case, I'm on HP Z240. Drivers, okay. And if you go here, then you will see that this is my computer. Select your operating system, in my case is Windows 11. If you don't see Windows 11 here on supported drivers, then choose Windows 10 and you will try, it will work. Most of the drivers will work, but some of them will not work or something, but let me know on comment, okay, then we can find drivers for you guys. Windows 11 version, this is the latest version, submit. Then you will see here all the drivers. In my case, I have the chipset here. Then I can download, I already have, it's installed, but we have some BIOS. Here it is. I have this BIOS update. I can download and do the update. So this is how you can find drivers manually, if it's impossible from Windows 11 to find drivers, okay? So I don't want to stuck more here. What I'm going to do, I will restart the computer. I'm going to install this update right now and restart the computer, okay? And then we will go on the tip number two. Tip number two is put the start menu on the left, okay? Let's make it like Windows 10. Guys, you see this start menu on the middle? I don't like on the middle, okay? I need the start here on the left. Right-click on task settings. Right-click here, you will see taskbar settings. I don't want widgets, just turn off. If you see task view here, turn off, I don't want it.
I don't like it. If you want, keep it. Other system, try icons, all of them. If you don't want them, just change it. Taskbar behaviors, taskbar alignment, center, I want it here on the left. You see? It's cool now. It looks like Windows 10, okay? And if you like to change some other things here on taskbar, here it is, you can manage it.
Tip number three, I know guys that when you right click on the desktop, you are expecting to see the old context menu. Here it is how you can enable it.
So the third tip for today, guys, I don't like this menu. You see this context menu? You have to click this show more options to see the old menu. But there is a tool for this. If you go here on tips to fix website, then you will find that video tutorial. You will see this video tutorial that I did, how to enable old right click menu. By default, you will see the link on the description for this tutorial, and go ahead and click and watch for details if you want. But here it is, the trick you can do with registry editor, okay, or with small software. I'm going to download, there is a tool here, go ahead in my website and find it, is this W11 Classic. It's nice, okay, just double click on this small software, and then if you want to enable classic context menu, click this button here, then you just need to restart your computer. I'm going to restart Explorer. Now, right click. You see, guys? You see, right click. And now I have old context menu, okay? And if you don't want it anymore, you want the new one, go ahead and enable the Windows 11 default context menu style, okay? So keep this small software on your desktop or whatever.
Tip number four is Windows 11 Debloater tool, okay? This incredible tool will remove unnecessary software, games, small softwares that you never use, okay? So let's remove from the system and give some more space for Windows 11 to work better, okay? Let's continue.
So another trick that you gotta do is Windows 11 Debloater, okay? Search for it. Go here on the GitHub link or go in my website and I will redirect you directly to the link. You see this Debloater tool, it's very important to see the stars, a lot of stars here, 4.5 key. Go ahead, let's go here on this. It's updated 4 days before. What we are going to do, just go ahead and download it. Here it is, download stable version. Debloater tool, let's bring here on a desktop, then open up Debloater tool, open terminal here, run as administrator. Now, what you are going to do here, let's scroll a little bit down. You see, if you want graphic design version, here, copy this code, okay? Then we'll bring it here, right click here on terminal, click enter, and then you will see this. You see a lot of options here, guys. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to only apply these tweaks. That's it's pre-built. So what this tool will do, it will remove all bloatwares, all the softwares, small softwares that are installed with your computer. Then it make your computer run slower, okay? Remove OneDrive, remove Xbox, and a lot of software like this, okay? And I just click this button here, apply tweaks. Then you will see that it's starting to apply. Then it will start applying the tweaks, okay? So this software start debloating your computer and removing all unnecessary softwares, okay? So in the moment that this Windows debloater is complete, like me here, you see, just close it and let's see. Oh, it changed the start. It starts, it looks smaller now. And if you want to see all apps, here it is. Now, I don't like this black for the moment, and I'm going to change the colors, and I will keep it light for the moment. And I suggest you this debloater because it's updated, okay? Now, next.
So in tip number five, we will remove some programs from startup. When your Windows start, a lot of softwares will start automatically and all of them will stay on the RAM. Most of them we don't need to run and stay on the RAM. And what we are going to do, we are going to disable from startup, and in the same time, we will manually uninstall some software that are not uninstalled from Windows 11 debloater, okay?
Right click here on Task Manager, click Task Manager, and then Startup Apps, Okay. If you don't want these softwares to run on your startup, then go ahead, right click on this and click disable. Okay. Okay. This is one method. Another method is we are going to go here on settings, apps. Here is startup apps. Make it bigger. You see, you can turn it off. You can turn off directly from here, guys. And let's say that you don't want this software. I don't want this mobile device to be running. So another tip is uninstall unnecessary applications. Go here, install apps. Now, uninstall some apps that you don't want it, okay? In my case, I will uninstall TikTok Live Studio. I don't need it. Uninstall it, guys. Uninstall the softwares that you don't want, okay? Xbox. I don't play games, so. And a lot of softwares that you don't want it, okay?
On the tip number 6, we are going to disable visual effects. 3D animation, visual effects on the computer, okay? All of these animation will be heavy for your graphic card, okay? So we need the graphic card for other processes. Let's continue.
Go to accessibility. Visual effects. This is really, really important. Go to visual effects. Now, you see these transparency effects? Remove this, turn off. Now, transparency effects is gone. Here on task menu, see the difference? You see the transparency here? Remove it. And animation effects, when I minimize like this, you see the animation effects? Turn off. Look, no more animation. Your computer will be faster, okay, believe me.
I like tip number 7, we will disable all notifications. I don't want notification in Windows 11. I mean, I don't want ads in the same time to show in Windows 11. And let's make some changes on a tweak privacy, okay?
And another trick here is notifications. Turn off notifications. And go here on privacy and security. And we have to disable ads, okay? General. Let Windows improve start and search result by tracking. I don't need tracking. If you see this option, let apps show me personalized ads, then click here to disable it, okay? I don't want this, I will disable. Show me notification in the settings app, disable it. So now make sure that you disable ads, but it's here on privacy and security.
On tip number 8, I'm going to check power savings, okay?
Power settings, edit power plan. Here on the power settings, power options, you make sure change advanced power settings. You have here balanced, active, but I want high performance, not power saver. If you keep power saver, it will make your computer laggy. High performance is better.
In tip number 9, I'm going to show you how to clear all the temp cache and in the same time storage sense and how to deal with that.
Tip number 9 is clear temp. Just search on start. Temporary files. You see here temporary files? I have 15 gigabytes temporary files, guys. And I will clean these device driver packages, temporary files. After we are done with that, and also downloads, go ahead and delete some download files. This is to remove some. If you remove these files, you will have more space on your computer, okay? Remove files and click continue. Now it's purging device driver packaging, and now you have more space on our C drive. Storage sense automatically free up space. Click on, keep it as it is, it's okay.
In tip number 10, let's clean your computer from viruses and do not install third-party antivirus, okay? Because it will slow down your computer. I'm going to show you how to deal with that.
Scan for viruses. You can use Windows Security, Windows Defender, like scan here, you know, quick scan. Use this Adwcleaner. With this small tool, you can, it's for free, it's just a tool. With this tool, you can clean your computer, okay? Scan your computer for any kind of viruses. Maybe this software will consider suspicious or something like this, you see? Or you can just quarantine if you don't want it.
We are not done yet. I have 3 more super suggestions. First of all, add more RAM on your computer, okay? Another suggestion is, if you are on old computer and if you are running on hard drive, it's super slow. Guys, you have to switch on SSD. I did a video tutorial for that, okay? How to switch from hard drive to SSD drive. And the last super suggestion is create your D drive. So partitionize your C drive. I did another video tutorial for that, okay? Go ahead, get your license for free. So thank you for watching this video tutorial, guys. Don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe my channel, and share this video with others, okay? And see you on the next video tutorial, okay? God bless you.